Good evening, parents and guardians, and welcome to our virtual new student orientation. So you have decided to send your child to the best school north of the South Pole. And a couple of the reasons why we say we are the best school north of the South Pole is because we have been an A school for 15 consecutive years. We have the largest ACE and AP capstone program in the world. And of course, our teachers are absolutely outstanding. So you might wonder what ACE and AP courses are. Those are college level courses. And yes, our ninth graders can be earning college credit in ninth grade. So we will push our students to take the most difficult course of study that they can possibly manage. But you have a great team of administrators here to help and to make sure that you are successful. So I hope you enjoy our virtual new student orientation.
Hi Bobcats, I'm Dr. Bradley. I'm one of our assistant principals. This is my 14th year at Boca High, and I work with students with the last names D and P. I wish you a wonderful school year ahead.
Hola. Hey. Oh my God. Bienvenidos a mi casa. I didn't know you guys were coming today. So I didn't dress at all. My office is a mess. But I'm gonna do my best to show my crib, so let's go. So let me show you a little bit. Since you're here already, let me show you what I have. For now, I have mi micrófono, a megaphone. I also have mi refrigerador, my fridge, where I keep all the healthy foods like sugar-free, gluten-free, whatever is free, so free that you can barely see it. But it's full there, you just can't see it. Also, now that you're here, come on, let's go, keep walking. It's a huge space, as you can see. This is where the magic happens, when I be with you. I go over everything that you need to know before you graduate. I have mi café, vodka cup. All right, let's go. So the only thing I have is mi teléfono. So I'm giving you a Spanish lesson today, parents. Now, let me show you one more thing about me. I'm a huge Dolphins fan. Miami Dolphins, numero uno. And then also, I'm gonna show you a little bit about mi familia, as you can see here. And one more thing you need to know about me is I like to travel. So now that I gave you the specifics, I wanna say that welcome to Boca High. I'm looking forward to meeting all of you, working with you. I'm in charge of facilities, the ESOL department. I oversee the after school program and the newly program that we have brought here was Latinos in Action or Latinos in Acción. And that's gonna be amazing. So also I'm in charge of anybody whose last name starts with an N or S. So it's your lucky year because we're gonna make it a great year. All right, so remember, do your best, be kind to one another, and always show respect for everybody. Welcome to Boca High.
Hi, Bobcats. I'm Mr. Corum. I'm one of the deans at our school. I serve family names H, I, L, and Z. I'm in charge of our AVID program, and I'm in charge of our Character Counts program. If you can't tell already, I'm from Buffalo, New York, so go Bills. I'm a huge Bills fan, and I'm also a jazz singer. A piece of advice for you, make sure you never tell a joke to an egg because they tend to crack each other up. And don't trust stairs, they're always up to something.
Hi, my name is Stephanie Lent. I'm one of the deans here on campus at Boca High. I oversee students with the last names that start with A, E, and W. I also oversee the AP testing program, so I'm the AP testing coordinator. I am co-coordinator for all testing other than AP, so EOC, FSA, SAT, ACT on campus. Also help with checking off your community service. So I check to make sure if what you're handing in is from a nonprofit organization. Remember, you need 20 hours of community service for graduation, by graduation, or 100 hours to reach the highest level of Bright Futures. Some interesting facts about me. I went to Penn State, so I am a die-hard college football fan. Go Penn State, Nittany Lions all the way. I'm a twin. We are not identical. We are fraternal, but it was pretty cool growing up as a twin. And finally, I'm originally from New Jersey, where our Real Housewives of New Jersey are from. So I taught there for 8 years prior to moving to Florida. Have a great day, Bobcats. Good to meet you.
Give me an F. Yeah, you got that F. You got that F. Give me an R. Yeah, you got that R. You got that R. Give me a Q. Yeah, you got that Q. You got that Q. Give me a Y. Yeah, you got that Y. You got that Y. Hi, Bobcats. My name is Dr. Lewis, and I'm a dean here at Boca Raton Community High School, and I look forward to working with all of my Bobcats, especially those with the last name F, Q, R, and Y. I just want to wish you a wonderful, wonderful super year. Go Bobcats!
How's it going, Bobcats? I'm Nick Lopes, and today I'll be filling in for Mr. Michaels. How's it going, guys? I'm Mr. Michaels. I'm in charge of last names B, K, and X. I'm also in charge of our AP Capstone program here at Boca High. Some fun facts about me is that I have 3 kids. I'm a huge Gators fan, an even bigger Tim Tebow fan. I used to play baseball, and I also used to be a math teacher. And being a good math teacher, of course I know some good math tricks. So here's a good one for you guys. What do you call dudes that like math? Algebros. Hope to see you guys soon. Miss you guys.
Hey Bobcats, this is Mrs. Sloan. I'm a dean of students here at Boca High. I handle students with the last name starting with a C or a J. I'm also responsible for clubs here on campus. A few things about me that you might not know. I have 5 kids. I also used to play volleyball in college. And lastly, for fun, I enjoy taking my motorcycle out for a nice quick ride. Let's have a seat here, Bobcats.
Hello, Bobcats. My name is Evan Wasserman, and I am one of the assistant principals. It's my 15th year at Boca High, and I handle students with the last names beginning with G, O, T, and U. I also handle dual enrollment, and I oversee our school's graduation. 3 interesting facts about me. I was born and raised in Boca Raton, Florida, as many of you are. I am a fan of all the hometown sports teams, so the Dolphins, the Heat, the Marlins and the Panthers, and I went to Indiana University. So let's have a great year. Go Bobcats!
Bobcats, this is Dr. Welter, one of the assistant principals here at Boca Raton High School. I'm responsible for overseeing students with the letters M and V. I want to welcome everybody here tonight, and I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about your high school experience as you come to Boca High. We know that this is a critical time in your lives. This is a time of uncertainty, and not just an uncertainty because we are going through a pandemic, but it is an uncertainty. As you go through the 4 years, naturally, you're going to be figuring out what it is you want to do with your lives. You're going to figure out what your likes and dislikes are, and it's more so a time of exploration. And as you go through these exploratory times, it's a time of collection. And when I say collection, I think that high school is about collecting keys. So what I really want to talk about is some keys to success. And I want to challenge you throughout these 4 years to gather these keys. So the first one is networking is an extremely important key to success. While you're here at Boca High, try to ensure that you are networking with students, trying to make connections, and communicating with your teachers, your classmates, because you never know who you're going to meet along the way that's going to be able to assist you in your path and your projection on where you're going to go. The second key to success is presentation and how you present yourselves. Once you are introduced to somebody new, obviously first impressions are extremely important. How do you carry yourselves? How do you dress? How do you interact? How do you present yourselves to society? And the third and most important one is education. And obviously at Boca High, that's one that we're going to focus on, is collecting the key of education, but education is the most important thing that nobody can ever take away from you. Education is a tool that you can use to express yourselves throughout the rest of your lives, to further your careers. So I want to end with a quote by Nelson Mandela, who says, education is the most powerful weapon you can use to change the world. We look forward to working with you guys, and hope for a great year. Thanks.
Hey, Bobcats, Coach Walker here. For those of you that don't know me, I'm the athletic director at Boca High. If there's one thing I've learned over these last 5 months of quarantine, it's to not take things for granted. That's why I go out and fish every chance I get. I'm switching up my strategy this school year. Instead of going out and catching bass, I'm gonna be at Boca High catching the best games, meets, and matches. Let's see what we can catch. Oh, I got a big one, you gotta get the net.
What up guys, it's Mr. H here, and I'm the BHP here at Boca High. I work closely with the assistant principals, the administration team, and the guidance counselors to provide you as much support as possible. Along with that, outside of school, I work with students from the ages of 5 all the way up to 18, helping them develop their basketball skills, which is my first love. I can't wait to meet all you guys. See you guys soon.
Hi, Bobcats. My name is Miss Reagan, and I will be the school counselor working with students with last names N, Q, R, and S. I grew up in New Jersey and went to college and grad school in Philadelphia. Go Birds. Some fun facts about me are I love to exercise and I love to do yoga, especially when I feel stressed. When I was in high school, my swim coach dated Michael Phelps and I got to meet him. And lastly, I'm a dog mom of 2 to Randy and Pearl. And as your school counselor, I'm here to help you with pretty much anything, so please don't hesitate to reach out to me. And let's make this an amazing year. Go Bobcats!
Hi, my name is Kimberly Carlo, and I'm excited to work with you and your families at Boca High. I work as a school counselor here, and I work with students' last names H, I, M, V, and Z. That's Dr. Welter and Mr. Corum. This is my second year at Boca High, and I really love the Bobcat family, and I can't wait to meet all of you. I moved here last year from New York with my family. I have a daughter who's in 10th grade here, and a son who's in 7th grade, and he's actually helping me make this video. When we are not at school, you can find me here at the barn, and this is my horse, Jet, and Jet is a retired thoroughbred. So some fun facts about me. I really enjoy riding. It's my passion and how I like to blow off steam. And I'm excited to hear and learn more about you guys and how you really de-stress from your days. I'm available for any kind of help, so please feel free to reach out if you need anything. And really looking forward to meeting and working with you all. Thank you.
Hi, Bobcats. I'm Miss Silversmith, and I am the school counselor who works with the students' last names starting with C, D, and J. I'm from Coral Springs. I went to FAU and graduated from there 3 different times, the most recent being with a specialist degree in school counseling. A little bit more about me, I really love sports. Baseball is my number one favorite. I grew up watching baseball. Every weekend I was at the field watching my brother play baseball. So that's really, I really do enjoy that. Another fun, interesting fact is that over the quarantine, I've come to find out that I really enjoy puzzles, and I've done like 10 to 15 different puzzles throughout the couple months of quarantine. My current situation right now with my puzzle. And that's a little bit about me, so I can't wait to meet you Bobcats and have a great start to your school year.
Hi, I'm Ms. Anderson, and I'm the guidance counselor for students, last name A-E-G-O-T-U. I've been working at Boca High for the last 6 years, but I've been supporting our school for longer. This jersey is my brother's. He's a former quarterback. Go Bobcats!
Hi, my name is Ms. Smith. I'm a second year school counselor here at Boca. I'm responsible for the students with the last name F-L-P-W-N-Y. Counselors can offer helpful suggestions on note-taking, managing your time, getting organized, overcoming test anxiety, and many more. Today with COVID, many students are stressed and overwhelmed with online learning. Feel free to reach out to me or any of the other counselors so we can go over some strategies to reduce your stress. One fun fact about me, I love going swimming in my downtime. Can't wait to hear from you, Ms. Smith.
Hi everybody, Dr. Beckford here, and I work with students last name beginning with B, K, and X. One fun fact about me is, if you haven't guessed already, I was born and raised in London, England, and my parents are from the beautiful island of Jamaica. I'm really looking forward to working with you all throughout the next year. Looking forward to meeting you all, even if it is via Google Classroom. Don't forget to get connected to my Google Classroom. Send me an email anytime, and remember that all of your counselors are here for you.
Hello and welcome to Boca High School. We are happy to have you as part of our family. My name is Lisa La Torre, ESOL Program Coordinator. We are here to support English language learners. We want you to learn and enjoy your time in high school. We believe in you and we walk with you. Once again, welcome.
Bienvenidos. Esta es la señora Martínez de Boca High. Yo soy la facilitadora de español en las clases, ayudándole a los profesores con los alumnos que necesitan el inglés. Bienvenidos de nuevo.
Olá, meu nome é Lia Jela, bem-vindos à Boca High. Eu sou tradutora de português e ajudo as famílias e os alunos nas aulas. Qualquer coisa, podem contar comigo.
Meu nome é Ernest Timam, no carreira de Miss I, eu traduzo crioulo. Nós somos já bem-vindos na escola Boca Return High School. N'importe que se alguém, eu quero sempre nos contactar no nosso oficial.
Good afternoon. My name is Pam Smith-Gondek, and I am the ESC coordinator. I work with students who have individual education plans, also known as IEPs.
Hello, Bobcats, and thank you for joining us tonight. This is Mrs. Sloan, and I'm here to talk to you about our ACE program here at Boca Raton Community High School. Our ACE coordinator is Eileen Kahn. She is going to be your best point of contact. If you have any further questions pertaining to this program, I'll make sure to include her email on our final slide. So what is ACE? ACE is an innovative and accelerated college prep program offered through Cambridge Assessment. What's great about this program is it maintains flexibility and choice by allowing our students to choose subjects at different levels. There's a broad curriculum with ACE that has a balance of maths and science, languages, arts and humanities, and interdisciplinary subjects. Why should students enroll in ACE courses? ACE courses have more weight, so by taking an ACE course, you are going to naturally increase your GPA or HPA, obviously still depending on how you do in the class, but because they carry more weight, they will contribute to a higher GPA or HPA. It also gives our students an opportunity to earn college credits and to also qualify for the ACE diploma, which has some scholarship perks that we'll discuss later on. The ACE diploma requirements. So in order to receive the ACE diploma, a student must accumulate 7 credits by passing ACE Global Perspectives AS level and at least one exam from 3 different subject groups. There is a time frame on this. Students are given 25 months to complete this once they take that initial course, that initial ACE course. So let's say a student starts their freshman year, their clock starts ticking then, and they have 25 months from that moment on. So that equates out to 3 years. So from freshman year until junior year, they'll have the time to accumulate those 7 credits in order to get the diploma. If a student does fail an exam during that time period, they are able to work with Eileen and retake that exam if they so please. You can see our groups listed below. So group 1 is our math and sciences group. Group 2 is our languages, Group 3 arts and humanities, and Group 4 is our interdisciplinary. One other sort of rule you need to be aware of is under Group 4, there is a max of 2 credits for this group, so the rest of the credits need to come from the other 3 groups. What I like about this and what I had mentioned before is you can see that there is a lot of variety. So students are really able to tailor based on their interests and work towards those 7 credits. The ACE Global Perspectives AS level, that gray box that you see at the bottom, that is the standalone requirement that I discussed earlier. All students, if they're wishing to get their ACE diploma, must pass that AS Global Perspectives AS level course. A few other advantages of the ACE diploma is for those that do receive it, they are exempt from the state of Florida's virtual class requirement and the personal fitness requirement. Okay, so talking about Bright Futures. So the Florida Bright Futures Scholarship is an opportunity for students to achieve full tuition in the state of Florida. Normally, the requirements to qualify for this program would be a GPA of 3.5 and test scores with an SAT of 1330 and an ACT of 29, as well as 100 community service hours. If a student does achieve the ACE diploma at Boca High, they are able to waive the GPA requirement and the test scores to achieve and receive the Florida Academic Scholars, 100% scholarship through Bright Futures Scholarship Program. So this is obviously very advantageous to many students, especially those who maybe struggle with test scores. It still gives them an opportunity to receive full tuition. They do still have to meet the 100 community service hours. That's a requirement that is not waived. But again, this is just an opportunity for students to still receive that 100%, waiving that GPA and the test scores requirement simply by getting their ACE diploma. Here at Boca High in 2020 alone, we had 1,841 students who took 4,904 ACE exams. We had a 72% pass rate, and 279 ACE diplomas were earned in 2020. As promised, Eileen's contact information is below, so if you have any further questions or are interested in this program, please feel free to reach out to her.
Hello, my name is Stephanie Lentz. I'm one of the administrators at Boca Raton High School and the AP testing coordinator. Today I'm going to speak to you about our pre-AP and AP programs. Our pre-AP program was created by the College Board to help students establish a rigorous foundation in high school as a means of preparing them for ACE and AP classes in the future. The main goal of our pre-AP program is to allow students the ability to become familiar with and comfortable with higher level thinking questions and the rigors that are found in those higher level classes, our ACE and AP classes, but without the high stakes environment, which means that the students at the end are not taking in a major end of course exam like they do in the ACE and the AP classes. And it wouldn't count for college credit quite yet. Our pre-AP courses are on the honors level, so they are out of a 4.5 on the HPA scale. Boca High was selected as one of 5 schools from over 1,000 that applied to be a College Board pre-AP partner, and we are the only school in Palm Beach County to be selected. We offer 5 courses at the pre-AP level: pre-AP World History and Geography, pre-AP English, pre-AP Biology, pre-AP Drama, and pre-AP Dance. Now that you know a little bit about our pre-AP program, let's dive into our AP program. So as many of you know, AP courses are created by College Board, and they are courses that are at the college level, but offered at high school. At Boca High, we offer these courses out of a 6.0 grading scale on the HPA. Courses that are at the AP level reflect courses that are taught in top introductory college courses. Students take AP exams at the end of the course, usually the first 2 weeks of May, that measure their mastery of college level work. One of the best parts about taking AP classes is a score of 3, 4, or 5 on an AP exam can earn students college credit and or a placement in advanced courses in college. We have many students that go through Boca High that take up to 8 AP classes their senior year, kind of working their way up, maybe 1 their freshman year, 2 their sophomore year, 3, 4 their junior year, and 8 up to 8 their senior year. With the amount of AP courses that you technically can take at Boca High, we do have many students that start their college careers at the sophomore level, meaning they have enough credits to go in and kind of bypass freshman year credit-wise. This is a really good opportunity. Not only does it save money at the college, but it also allows students to start their work at in their major much quicker. Why should you take AP courses? Students learn rigorous college-level content and skills in classes that are interesting, and they're filled with rewarding academic experiences. AP courses challenge learners to work and participate at a higher level, giving students opportunities to explore topics deeply through critical thinking, synthesis, and analysis. AP courses speak to college admission officials. It tells them that students are challenging themselves and preparing for the rigors they'll encounter in their college career, that they're going that one extra step. Nationally, research shows that students who score a 3 or higher on AP exams typically earn higher grade point averages in college and have higher graduation rates. Boca High has an extensive list of AP course offerings. We offer a total of 30 AP courses. It is one of the most in the district. We offer our AP capstone classes, which are AP seminar and research, which I'll be diving into momentarily. We offer many courses in the arts, English, history and social sciences, mathematics and computer sciences, sciences, and world languages. We are very excited this year to be bringing back our computer science principles course. As you can see, we really have a plethora of courses that really range and hit every area of discipline and every area of interest. So our goal here at Boca High is to offer courses that will speak to every type of student, every interest of students. Some AP course statistics from this past year. This year, we gave 3,736 exams. Due to COVID-19, exams looked a little different, but we are hoping to go back to the traditional exams this year. We had an amazing year of exam results. We went up 8% for students that earned a level 3, 4, or 5, which is a passing score. We are up to 71% of our students earning a passing score, which is phenomenal. Last year, we offered 29 AP classes, and 23 out of those 29 AP class pass rates was higher than the national average. College Board does something really wonderful to recognize students. They recognize students at various levels that they call AP scholars, depending on the number of AP exams that they have passed. At Boca High this past year, we had 685 students get recognized as AP scholars. that is up from 655. We had 358 AP scholars, 119 AP scholar with honors, 172 AP scholar with distinction, 35 national AP scholars, and for the first time, 1 AP international diploma. What that means is a student here at Boca High has decided to use those credits to apply to an international university. We also offer our AP capstone diploma. That's the highest level that you can take here at Boca High. In order to get the AP Capstone Certificate, you must pass research and seminar. We had 160 students reach that goal this past year. And our AP Capstone Diploma, which I'll be diving into more, is passing seminar, research, and four other AP exams. And this year we had 150 students reach that milestone. So what is AP Capstone? AP Capstone program is offered through College Board, and it helps students to understand and learn how to write a research paper. Boca High is very proud to be the largest AP Capstone program in the world. We have had College Board come and observe us. We've had other states come and look at our AP Capstone program, and we have become a model for the AP Capstone program around the world. The AP Capstone program provides rigorous foundation. They are allowed to dive into topics of their interest. It promotes critical and creative thinking, and it allows the students to plan and conduct studies. One of the new perks of the AP Capstone diploma is, or program and diploma, is that it really allows students to to make themselves stand out, add a really wonderful thing to quote unquote their resume. So the AP Capstone diploma is now a distinction on common application or other college applications. So that really, if a student is going for that, it could really put them in a higher category when applying for admissions. So who takes that, the AP Capstone program? We love to start the AP Capstone program in ninth grade. We do have 10th and 11th graders that start it. We have a lot of 10th graders and then some 11th graders. In order to start the program as a ninth grader, you have to have earned a level 4 or 5 on the reading FSA. The AP Capstone program is designed to start as a 2-year program. So in the first year of the program, students take AP Seminar paired with ACE Global Perspectives. In the second year of the program, they take AP Research and ACE Global Perspectives. You might have heard Ms. Khan speak about that ACE Global Perspectives is a research class as well. So what we do here at Boca High is we've decided to put those two together. So instead of writing 2 5,000-word paper by the end, they're only writing one, and they're tweaking it based off of College Board requirements and ACE requirements. AP Capstone program progression. As stated, it is a 2-year commitment. So let's say students start this commitment in ninth grade. The plan would be that they take ACE General Paper, and that is backed up, so the next class on their schedule would be AP Capstone Seminar Block. So that is the AP Capstone and the ACE Global Perspectives 1AS. Ninth grade students that are in that block tend to also take ACE Marine and AP Environmental Science Block. Once they have completed in their first year their seminar, ACE General Paper, and seminar, they move into AP Research and ACE Global Perspectives 1A. This is only if, they can only go into that research class if they have successfully completed and passed the AP Capstone Seminar exam. How do I complete the AP Capstone program? So in order to fully complete the program, that's going to end up leading students to earn their AP Capstone diploma. In order to get that diploma and complete the program, students must take and pass AP Seminar, AP Research, and 4 other AP courses and exams. Those 4 other AP courses and exams can be taken at any point throughout their high school career. As students work their way towards the AP Capstone Diploma, they can earn the AP Seminar and Research Certificate. That means that they have successfully passed their AP seminar and AP research classes, but may not have yet earned the rest of those four AP courses and exams, passing scores. AP seminar, which is year one, is a foundational course that provides students with opportunities to think critically and creatively, research, explore, pose solutions, develop arguments, collaborate, and communicate using various media. Students read articles, research studies, foundational philosophical texts, listen to and view speeches, broadcast and personal accounts, and experience artistic and literary works to gain a rich application of understanding of these issues. Teachers have the flexibility to choose themes that allow for deep exploration. So they can focus on themes that maybe align with local or civic issues or global or international topics that are occurring at the time, as well as student interests. At the end of their AP seminar, they have worked on their research skills. They take a performance task and a couple of performance tasks and a written exam. After successfully completing AP seminar, they can move on to AP research. This is the second course in the capstone experience, and it allows students to design, plan, and conduct a year-long research-based investigation on a topic of individual interests. That topic must be presented to the teacher and obviously approved. Once students dive into this, this is when it gets exciting for a lot of the students because they really see all their hard work from AP seminars start to come to fruition. Students are assessed through culminating performance tasks, which include a 5,000 word paper, public presentation, performance, and exhibition, and oral defense of research and presentation. I know this sounds very overwhelming, and I've just explained a lot of information to you. What I can tell you is the administrative team here at Boca High is here to guide your child and you students on the path that is right for them. We are going to push your students to try and pull out the very best that they can do. We want them to reach their highest potential. And we're going to do that through proper guidance. If they're starting at the pre-AP level, we're going to help guide them on a path to reach those ACE and AP courses. If they are starting at the ACE and the AP level, we're going to steer their path so that they are taking the best classes for them that pique their interest, as well as that really give them a overall great foundational educational experience here at Boca High and get to that final goal of hopefully that AP capstone diploma. Every student is different. Every student is academically different. And we promise to help guide your child and you students in the correct direction. If you have any questions, please always feel free to reach out. I'm here to help. I hope you all have a great day and good luck on your upcoming year. I know you all are going to do great.
Yes to these questions, then you may be suffering from freshmanitis.
If you are, don't worry. I was there once too. We have a cure for you. Boca High School Spirit.
Side effects of school spirit may include bleeding blue and gold, making new friends, having beef with Spanish River, and in extreme cases, some patients have reported going to school on Spirit Week wearing over-the-top outfits. Say goodbye to freshmanitis with school spirit.
How's it going, guys? I'm Nick Lopes from Mr. Boca High. I'm going to go pick up Hannah so we can give you guys a proper introduction to high school.
Yo, Hannah!
What's up, Nick?
Want to go show the freshmen about Boca High?
Yeah, let's go! Hi, I'm Hannah Youssef.
And I'm Nick Lopes.
And we're your Mr. and Miss Boca High.
Although we can't see you in person right now, we can't wait to meet you all.
I know transitioning from middle school to high school may be hard, but trust me, these next 4 years are going to be the time of your lives.
Coming from a small private school, I never expected to be Mr. Boca High. Always worried about making friends, fitting in, but here I am 4 years later.
At Boca High, there are many different opportunities to get involved at school and create lifelong friendships. Even though we're online, Nick and I are going to make sure that everyone will have an amazing freshman year.
Also know that the transition from middle school to high school can seem overwhelming, but it's important to remember that everyone is on the same boat as you are.
The biggest advice I'd give you entering high school is to just join clubs, play sports, and just be involved at your school. I know that sounds cliche to say, but trust me, at the end of your high school experience, you're going to appreciate that you partook in all these activities and you don't want to leave high school having any regrets.
Although it's hard to tell what this year is going to look like, it's still important to try to join as many clubs as possible and get involved and participate in school spirit and other activities such as that. Some of my best memories from the past 3 years have been school activities such as staying up late, setting up for homecoming, watching the boys' powder puff dance, and A push day in Mr. Green's class.
Another piece of advice I'd like to give you guys is to never be too afraid to ask for help, especially during distance learning. If you guys are struggling or need help, feel free to shoot your teachers an email. Although they can seem intimidating, they're your biggest ally and are here to help.
I know when I started high school, the best advice I got was to be involved as much as possible in clubs, sports, and other school activities. And now I'm passing that same advice on to you.
We're not just here to spread school spirit, but to also make sure that everyone at Boca High has everything they need to succeed.
We were freshmen too once, so we know what y'all are going through.
I know you may be nervous about studying and staying on track, but as long as you have a quiet place to study on the side, you'll do fine.
Yeah.
Being involved and having school spirit can have an immense impact on your high school experience.
Also, elections are going to be coming up for class officer positions. These positions are for freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and seniors. The elections are going to be held 3 weeks after school starts, and it's all going to be virtual. There's going to be an election meeting that everyone who has the intent to run should be attending. The Google Classroom code is right here, and make sure you join for more updates. The positions that you can run for in each grade are president, vice president, treasurer, secretary, historian, and delegate at large. The job of the freshman, sophomore, junior, and senior class officers is to host pep rallies and attend meetings to focus on fundraising for the class. If you ever need anything, please feel free to reach out to me on my Instagram.
And my Instagram here.
And don't forget to follow Boca the Bobcat. Thanks for watching, everyone. Let's have an amazing year.
I showered for no reason this morning.
That's okay. I don't shower.
He said one day you leave this world behind. So live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights to never die. My father told me. One day.